Hong Kong is in recession. Let's have a look. Hello everyone, Florian Heiser here and welcome to another episode of Heiser Says. Hong Kong is officially in recession. So we have an article here that I'd like to go through. Before we go through this, let's have a look at just some information about the economy in Hong Kong. So they are 0.59 with economic complexity. And this is the Observatory of Economic Complexity, a website that I love. They're 38th in the world. So they are a much more advanced economy to Australia. Their exports, 136 billion. Their imports are 601 billion. And their GDP per capita is 61,000 or 61 and a half. So, I mean, if you look at their exports, we'll just compare that to Australia, we're 243 and Hong Kong is 136. So for their land area, they are pretty damn big. Just puts Aussies into perspective, doesn't it? Their imports though are three times what ours are. Three times what ours are. So they're gonna have an impact on the country that they're importing from, or the country. So Hong Kong is the 33rd largest export economy in the world, 38th most complex economy according to the ECI. In 2017, Hong Kong exported 136 billion and imported 600 billion, resulting in a negative trade balance. In 2017, the GDP of Hong Kong was 341 billion and its per capita was 61.5 billion. So let's just jump here and look at Australia. What is our GDP? You know, we're sitting at, you know, ours is 1.32. That was our GDP. So, you know, we are doing okay compared to Hong Kong. We are doing okay. And what we'll do is we'll jump back to here. So, top exports of Hong Kong are gold, broadcasting equipment, integrated circuits, diamonds, telephones, and, okay, some other data. So, you can see here what they're exporting. It is no surprise that they are a more advanced economy than Australia. And what they're importing, integrated circuits, broadcasting equipment. So they're value adding to a lot of the things they're importing. And the destination for their exports, China, number one, it looks like. Thailand, other Asia, bit of Switzerland. I wonder what's going to Switzerland. Anyone can guess? Origins, 42%. Of their imports are from China and Singapore. Australia, we're 2.3%. So that, you know, China, Singapore, Asia, South Korea, and Japan. So a decline in the economy of Hong Kong is going to have implications for all of the countries that they're importing from. So we can have a look here, look at the unemployment rate, and it's up at 2.9%. We'll zoom out to have a look at the data. So it's been below 4% for a while. The GFC, it shot up. Went down. We'll look at their interest rates. They're just below 2.5%. Look at the max data. They were sitting, wow, from the GFC. Look at that. They've crept up, heading back down. And here's a good one. Business confidence. Boom. Look at the last data there. Down negative 25. And it's, yeah, business confidence isn't very good. We all know what's happening in Hong Kong at the moment with the protests and with a lot of the attempts at the central government over on the mainland trying to impose their will. So Hong Kong officially enters recession with zero growth expected for the remainder of 2019. Hong Kong has fallen into recession and is unlikely to achieve any growth this year following almost 5 months of anti-government protests, the city's financial secretary says. The blow from protests to our economy is comprehensive, Paul Chan said in a blog post, adding that a preliminary estimate for third quarter GDP on Thursday would show two successive quarters of contraction, the technical definition of a recession. He also said it would be extremely difficult to achieve the government's pre-protest forecast of 0.1% annual economic growth. Over the weekend, black-clad and masked demonstrators set fire to shops and hurled petrol bombs at police on Sunday, following a now familiar pattern with police responding with tear gas, water cannon, and rubber bullets. TV footage shows protesters who streamed into the Kowloon Hotel and shopping district of Nathan Road, setting fire to street barricades and squirting petrol from plastic bottles onto fires at subway entrances amid running battles with police. At one station, activists rolled a flaming metal barrel down a long staircase towards police below. The rallying cry of Sunday's protests was to fight perceived police brutality and defend Muslims and journalists. The police last weekend fired water cannon at a group of people standing outside a mosque, and journalists have been wounded in clashes. So journalists are criticizing the police for excessive force. So the Programming Staff Union of public broadcaster RTHK said on Monday it had called on police to identify officers who attacked and ripped the face mask off one of its journalists on Sunday. It said she was wearing a reflective vest, clearly identifying her as a journalist. Pictures circulated online suggesting she was wearing a gas mask to protect her against tear gas and pepper spray. Ordinary face masks were banned this month under a resurrected colonial era emergency law. Well, there you are. Hong Kong Free Press, a local news website, called for the release of a freelance photographer arrested on Sunday after she had asked to see a police officer's warrant card. The city's Foreign Correspondent Club condemned the arrest in a statement calling for an independent investigation into police violence against journalists and interference with the media's right to cover the protests under Hong Kong law. The police, who deny using excessive force, told reporters they'd repeatedly asked journalists to keep their distance so police can do their job. They said an officer had removed a journalist's mask, which had seemed an undesirable incident, but they said they did not know the full context. The HKFP reporter was arrested for failing to show ID and being uncooperative and obstructing police. So tourism to the city dropped 50% in October. I can't say it's surprising when these are the images that are going around the world. Who wants to, well, go on a holiday to Hong Kong now? I have fond memories of Hong Kong. It is a lovely city, particularly the island. But, I mean, is it going to be possible? Do you think China? Do you think China would allow a free and independent Hong Kong? I can't see the CCP allowing that. I cannot see it happening, not without a conflict. Protesters have routinely torched storefronts and businesses, including banks, particularly those owned by mainland Chinese companies, and vandalized the city's MTR Corp Metro, which has shut down services to stop protesters gathering. MTR had closed early for the past few weeks and said it will again shut down 2 hours early on Monday to repair damage. Protesters are angry about what they view as increasing interference by Beijing in the former British colony, which returned to Chinese rule in 1997 under a 50-year one-country-two-systems formula intended to guarantee freedoms, common law, and British capitalism not found on the mainland. Well, I mean, it's only 50 years, guys. Time is running out. They need to start putting their pressure on there. What's going to happen at the end of that period? China denies meddling. It has accused foreign governments, including the United States and Britain, of stirring up trouble. What do you reckon? Could that be? Tourist numbers have plummeted, with visitor numbers down nearly 50% in October, a decline Mr. Chan called an emergency. Retail operators, from primary shopping malls to family-run businesses, have been forced to close for multiple days over the past few months. While authorities have announced measures to support local small and medium-sized enterprises, Chan said the measures could only slightly reduce the pressure. Let citizens return to normal life, let industry and commerce operate normally, and create more space for rational dialogue, he wrote. So there you are, everyone. We are seeing, well, I can't say anyone is surprised that Hong Kong is in a recession, considering what's happening. So Preliminary estimates for third quarter GDP showed the city is officially in recession. A recession happens when an economy contracts over two successive quarters. And Hong Kong's tourist numbers plunged 50% in October. That is a huge decline, and I can't say anyone is going to be surprised. What is concerning, aside from just the struggles of the people there to get freedom, is it's going to have wider implications to the entire Asian region, and, well, for us here in Australia, that's going to flow onto us too. Anyway, guys, please let me know your thoughts. Like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you all again later today. I'm just trying to find my outro. Take care.